His shield will be my safety. When stones across my pathway lie, on angels' wings I'm carried.
Good evening and welcome to Ending the Day with God on Tuesday the 28th of March. Welcome to Live Lent, God's story, our story. A series of stories, prayers and meditations for the evenings of Lent. This evening our theme is, Who Are We? And our opening music was My Dwelling Place by Keith and Kristin Getty. And our opening prayer. God of all seasons, in your pattern of things, there is a time for keeping and a time for losing, a time for building up and a time for pulling down. In this holy season of Lent, as we journey with our Lord to the cross, help us to discern in our lives what we must lay down and what we must take up. What we must end, and what we must begin.
Amen.
Holy and strong one,
forgive our weakness.
Holy and wise one,
forgive our foolishness.
Holy and loving one,
forgive our hardness.
Holy and generous one,
forgive our selfishness.
Holy and faithful one,
forgive our fickleness.
Holy and gentle one,
forgive our toughness.
Forgive us, Holy One, forgive.
So our theme, Who Are We, this evening has a reading from St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 7. One of the Pharisees asked Jesus to eat with him, and he went into the Pharisee's house and took his place at the table. And a woman in the city, who was a sinner, having learned that he was eating in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster jar of ointment. She stood behind him at his feet, weeping, and began to bathe his feet with her tears and to dry them with her hair. Then she continued kissing his feet and anointing them with the ointment. Thanks be to God. The Gospel addresses four deep questions about human experience. And the first is, who are we? This story tells us at least three things about this woman, and by implication, about us. First, she is a sinner. The implication of the story is that she may be a prostitute. But according to Christian tradition, we are all sinners, people who get things wrong and fall short. Sometimes, sadly, Christians seem to stop at this point. Second, though, she is a person of infinite value, made in the image of God, worthy of love and acceptance. She is aware of her own brokenness and capable of repentance and change, as we all are. And third, she is created for worship, for relationship with God, symbolized in the lavish extravagance of her gesture. And this too is true for all of us. It is who we are. Amen. And now, as our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, God, that you have made us in your image, made us for worship and for love, for relationship with you. Help us to see all people as you see us. Amen.
Now, closing responses. Father, in the awareness of your presence, beneath the shadow of your wings, in the closeness of your love,
may we abide.
Jesus, in the fellowship of your saints, in the communion of the faithful, in the church called to mission,
may we abide.
Spirit, in the power of your love, in the fullness of your gifts, in the guidance of your wisdom,
may we abide. Amen.
The Lord who conquered darkness with light, give peace to you. The Lord who conquered death with life, give peace to you. The Lord who conquered loneliness with love, give peace to you.
Amen.